everyone, it's Lisa here and welcome back to my channel. So yes, I have another shoe reveal video, and if you saw my last shoe reveal video, I did say I had no intentions of purchasing any more shoes anytime soon. However, I did actually say that I wanted a certain pair of shoes and I posted a picture of them, but I said I wasn't getting them anytime soon just because the price of them was crazy and outrageous and I didn't want to pay for them. So I actually picked them up, but I didn't pay full retail price for them. I actually got them for a great price, and that's the reason that I picked them up. So let me just show you the box. They are a pair of beautiful Valentino shoes, and they came in this beautiful red box. And since I've gotten a lot of questions about these shoes, I just figured I would also make it into a review video and answer a few of the questions that I got and just go over a few details of the shoe. So this is the box that you will get. It says Valentino Garavani in black writing, and it will have this V symbol on the front in a circular pattern, and red is actually the signature color for Valentino. And let's just show you what I got. So the inside looks like this. Of course, you'll get all this paper stuff, and they're packaged like this. And what I got is these beautiful gold Rockstud pumps, and they are in this beautiful gold textured leather, and the color is like a bronze color, metallic, and the name of this color is called Sasso, S-A-S-S-O, and I'll put all the information in the description bar below. I think these are absolutely beautiful, and I really wanted this color just because it's a great neutral color without it being just your typical nude or, you know, just a flat. It kind of actually has a little bit of extra life in them. And as far as the price of these shoes, the actual retail price of them right now is $1,045 in the US. So I honestly think that price is ridiculous, and that's coming from a person that actually likes shoes and luxury items. But yeah, so that's just my personal opinion. Like I said, I didn't pay the full retail price. Where I actually got these from was from Tradesy. And they are a new unused pair of shoes, and they were actually on there for like $800 and something. And then they had a sale where you could get like $50 or $75 off. So I got that off, and then I had some Tradesy credits, so I applied that. And then I also had some Ebates, you know, refunds, and, you know, through PayPal, and some other things that I sold. So I basically only ended up paying like $600 and something for these, so that's a great price, way down from $1,000. $45, so I don't know, that's why I picked them up. Inside of the box you will get a red dust bag like this, and it's this nice soft like felt like material. It's a drawstring dust bag, and sorry I dropped some of the things out, but it's a drawstring dust bag, and it has like these black leather like straps at the top. And sorry, all the envelopes fell out, but you'll get this tab right here, and then this says Valentino Garavani, made in Italy. And you will also get these envelopes that come in here. So these envelopes are actually very important. Always make sure you get them. Sometimes when you get these shoes, these may be missing, but they are supposed to come with your shoes, so If you don't get them, I will call up the store or go back in there and ask for them. When these shoes first came out, they actually didn't come with them, but now they do. And what's in here, you will get 2 replacement studs, and they're basically just the studs, same exact studs that come with your shoes in case they come off. And so you can replace them, because every now and then they do come off. And I actually did a video on a pair of shoes that I had, which the stud came off and I took them to be repaired. So I will link that video below. But you can take them into a Valentino boutique and they will replace your studs for free, and also at certain other retailers. In the other envelope, you will get an extra pair of heel tabs. And in the other envelope, you get a care information booklet in different languages. So these shoes come in a variety of different styles, and they come in flats. They come in flats with an ankle strap. They come in wedges. They have sandals now, boots. Obviously, they have purses and different accessories. They have the kitten heel, which has like the 3 straps that go around the ankle, which is a 2.5-inch heel. And then you have these, which are probably the most popular style. These are a 4-inch heel with the 100 millimeter heel, and they all have basically, you know, the pointed toe. And where you can purchase them from different retailers, which is like obviously Valentino Boutiques. You can purchase them at places like Saks, Nordstrom, Bergdorf Goodman, Neiman Marcus. You can also get them online at places like Net-a-Porter and Farfetch. And Farfetch is actually a great place to buy them. Sometimes they are quite a bit cheaper on there. Right now, I think the prices are about the same as most of the retailers, but a lot of the times the prices are cheaper on there, so I would definitely go and check them out. I've actually never paid full retail price for any of the ones that I own. And on Farfetch, you can get them. You don't have to pay for tax. You don't have to pay extra import fees. Whatever the price is, that's a price that you pay. But I would wait until, like, a lot of times they offer free shipping. So you could, you know, save also on the shipping when they offer that. And I will leave actually a coupon code below, where you can get a discount. They offer a discount on your very first order, and I'll leave that below. I don't get anything from it, but you know, you guys are welcome to use it. I think it's like 10% off your first order. Another pair that I have. So patent leather was the original and probably the most popular material that they come in, with the nude straps. And they also come in smooth leather. They come in like this textured leather, like this pebbled leather. They come in, I've seen them in pony hair. They have some with crystals on them. Just a lot of different textures. And then they come in multiple colors, obviously. Probably your most popular colors are black, the nude color, and the red, which is their signature color. And a lot of people say like the nude color is kind of like a weird nude color. It kind of has like a bluish purplish undertone, so some people say that it doesn't look flattering on certain skin tones. So I would just go in and try them on and see if you like the way that they look on you. When these shoes first came out, I never really liked them. I actually thought they were kind of ugly. I don't know, they were just weird looking. And then, I don't know, they just seemed too trendy. And then, I don't know, everybody just had them. everybody and their mother, and so I didn't like that. They were just everywhere, all on Instagram, all these blogs, all these celebrities were wearing them. It was just like too much, and I was just over it and sick of them. But then I came around and liked them. It took me like 4 years. Like, it's 2015, they came out in the year 2010. And I don't know, now I like them. So they were just different. When they came out, they were a huge hit because they were just so different than any shoe that was out. It's just a versatile shoe. It's just different. It's very edgy, yet it's a very classy and sexy and feminine shoe that it's hip and a little bit rebellious because of the studs. And I don't know, I always get a lot of compliments when I wear these shoes, and it's almost kind of actually strange because just random strangers will come up to me, men, women, and just tell me how much they like my shoes. Actually, my husband thinks it's just really weird. He just can't believe it. I love the shoe just because it's so versatile. Like, you could, it's an easy shoe to wear with a lot of different things. So you can wear it with dresses, you can wear them with pants or trousers, you can wear them with skinny jeans, leggings, you can wear them even with shorts if you have the legs for it. A lot of different things. And it's an easy shoe to transition from a daytime look all the way to a nighttime look. So you could wear them, you know, casually, you can wear them like to brunch, and then you can wear them to a formal event or to a wedding, or, you know, it's just a very versatile shoe, and you can get a lot of wear out of them and use them for a lot of different looks. So as far as the design of the shoe, it has this pointed toe, and the pointed toe along with these open cage style strappy shoes actually makes your legs and your ankles look slimmer, and it makes your legs look longer just because they're open. And then it has this strap right here. As you can see, it has a sling back, and it has this one strap that goes around, and actually this strap cuts just below like your ankles, so it doesn't cut your legs off. So even if you have shorter legs, it's still a flattering shoe. And as far as the heel height, it's just a 4-inch heel, which is usually pretty comfortable for most women. Like 3.5 to 4 inches is usually a pretty comfortable heel height for most women. And it, you know, the pitch or the slope isn't too steep. It does have a padded footbed, but I always like to put like one of these extra little foot pads in here, just right here in the sole of the shoe, just to make it a little bit more comfortable so you can wear them, you know, a little bit longer. Since it is a single-soled shoe, it doesn't have a platform, so that makes it a little bit more comfortable. And as far as the strap, so like I said, it's an open cage style strap shoe with these really soft leather straps. So I don't know what or how they made these straps, but they're actually super comfortable. Usually straps like this will dig into your foot or cut into your foot, but these don't. And as you can see, like, these are new, so they sit up. But these other ones I have, you know, they've softened, so they lay down a little bit more. So if you get them and they're a little bit tight, I wouldn't worry about that too much because they do stretch. But they mold to your foot so well. Like, your feet feel really secure in these. They don't feel like they're gonna slip out or anything. As far as the craftsmanship, just always make sure you inspect them. Make sure that the studs are evenly spaced. Try to make sure that they're not crooked or twisted. And you always want to make sure that they're flat against the shoe. There's no spaces, no loose studs or anything like that. As far as the sole of the shoe, you should see this stamp right here. The sizing should always be in Italian sizing. So like these say 37.5. I should always be like 37 something or 40, 41, always in Italian sizing, never in like a size 7 or something like that. That's basically not an authentic shoe if you see that. And the sole, like this sole, is actually the softer leather, whereas like on these patent leather shoes, it's more of the harder like plastic type sole. As far as this on the insole of the shoe, it should say Valentino, and it should be stitched on all four sides. So not just one side or not just two sides, it should be stitched on every single side, and it should say Valentino Garavani, and then it should have that Valentino symbol right there. And another thing I just wanted to mention about the sole, as far as the wear on the shoe, you will see this tip, this pointed part right here. That's where you will tend to see a lot of the wear on the shoe, which is actually normal for any pointed toe shoe. So if you saw my video with the repair of the shoes that had the stud come off, the bottom did have the tip replaced by a cobbler, just because that's where it tends to wear. So as far as the sizing of the shoe, I would suggest you go up at least a half a size. So my size is actually, this is kind of a different kind of shoe just because it's closed toe here, but then this part is open. So as you guys know, I have pretty narrow feet. So in closed toe shoes, I normally would wear a 7. But in open strappy type shoes like this, I would have to wear a 6.5. But these shoes, I actually decided to get in a 7.5. However, these patent leather ones, I actually got in a 7. But I feel like the 7.5 is actually a better fit for me. So the 7s actually fit, you know, very well. The thing that you want is that you don't want your heel to be hanging off the back of the shoe. That is totally not attractive and most likely not comfortable. The 7s fit me lengthwise very well, but I just feel like these I had to maybe wear or stretch a little bit more. But actually, you know, patent leather is a stiffer material. You know, these I just feel like I can just put on and just go. And, you know, like I wouldn't have to stretch them or wear them at all. The only place like I kind of had to stretch them a little bit or wear them was just like this area right here. But, you know, the straps have softened over time. Like I said, they just mold to your feet. They get softer. I would go up at least a half a size. Or if you have wide feet, I would suggest maybe going up even a whole size. But just try to try them on. You know, it's individual, but at least a half a size. So I think that's about it for my review. I think I've covered mostly everything I wanted to say. If I forgot anything or if you have any other questions, just leave them below. I will try to answer them. So thank you guys so much for watching. I will have another video coming up on this cute little bag that I picked up this weekend, but I will do that in a separate video. So make sure you subscribe, and you can always follow me on Instagram. I'll put my Instagram name here below or in the description bar. And thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you on my next video.